on, everyone. I hope everyone is staying safe and healthy. Connor Fairbrass, also known as That Guy at Ford, coming at you with another video walk around, this time on a special new product that I'm specializing in, 2021 Ford Bronco Sport. This is the Badlands package. Let's get right into the walk around. Starting right up at the front of the 21 Bronco Sport Badlands, as you can see, it does come with LED style headlights. It seems to be a big trend that Ford is running with for 2021 models and forward. You see, you've got a LED halo with an LED running light leading you right into the Bronco badging and the front grille. Now, that's actually a little bit of a paid homage to the 60s Bronco with the round headlight. Up at the front, with it being a Badlands package, it does have a 360 camera, sorry, a front camera on, so when you're approaching your obstacle, or even when you're approaching something in the parking lot, you'll be able to, if you click that button on the inside, you can get a forward view of it. Now, the Badlands package is also going to get you tow hooks on the front here, because the Badlands package does have a 1-inch higher ground clearance compared to the lesser models. Super, super important is if you ever decide to take the vehicle off-road in an adventure, you're gonna wanna have front tow hooks. In that case, you might get stuck. Now, let's jump under the hood and we'll go through what the power plant is for the Badlands specifically.
Something new that I wanna highlight as we're making our way under the hood here is some of our vehicles for 2021 and onwards are gonna have a double pull hood release. So the Bronco Sport is one, the Ford Escape is also one, so you have to pull it twice, once, twice, and then make your way up to the front and unlock the hood.
Now, to open up the hood, like you saw inside, you double pull the lever, and you simply just have to lift the hood up. There's no more fiddling underneath here trying to find the lever to release it. It's a double latch hood release here on the front. All you gotta do, pull this guy up, put your hood prop in, boom, and you're good to go. Now, it's gonna expose on the Badlands model. You get the 2-liter EcoBoost engine, so the 4-cylinder turbocharged engine. This engine is specific to the Badlands. You cannot get a base, big bend, or outer banks with the 2-liter. It is only available in the Badlands. 250 horsepower, 277 pound-feet of torque. Great little engine. I had the chance to drive it around. It drives awesome. I was worried it was gonna drive just like an Escape. It does not drive just like an Escape. It drives quite different enough that you can really notice it's a very, very different design, and Ford didn't want to make it seem like a lot like an Escape. They want to change up. You can definitely notice that. Now, let's jump into the driver technology at the front and we'll make our way around the vehicle.
So like I mentioned earlier, you do have a front facing camera. Now you do have a washer there. So there is a button on the dash that you can see as I click it. It's gonna pull up a front camera view. So you can use that if you're coming towards another vehicle in a parking spot, off-roading, however you wanna use it. There's a lot of different uses when you're at the low speeds. Now, just like most of the other Ford vehicles that's coming out for 2020 and 2021, you're gonna have a handful of driver assistance packages. So your sensor here in the front, you're gonna have your forward collision, things like lane keep. Got another little sensor up at the top there, does things like auto rain sensing wipers. Now, making our way over to the side, you got a note, little note here, accessory ready on both driver and your passenger side. Basically what that means is you can pull this guy up and you can have your roof racks, you can put tents on there. You've got a handful of different racks for kayaks, bikes, handfuls of different things. There's a load of different options available. Now, at the side here, I do want to point out you have a really cool little kind of ridge in the roof here. So a little bit lower on the front end here for the driver and the passenger, but it does kick up a little bit here, which helps for, you know, tall guys like myself at 6'4", that it's gonna give you a little bit more headroom. So really, really nice. You can see as I pan up here, you can see where it kind of kicks up right here. It falls all the way back, all the way to the back of the Sport. Gives you a lot more headroom. It just makes it a lot more comfortable. Now, don't get me wrong, there's still quite a bit of headroom on the front for the driver and the passenger. It's just, it's a little bit lower when you have the power moonroof there as well too. Now, we'll kick back out to the side and we'll show you everything new on the side.
Now, of course, with the Bronco Sport being a all new vehicle, it's gonna have all new fenders. There's nothing really reused on this Bronco from any of our other current Ford vehicles in the lineup. Starting up with the front, kind of making our way through the side, we've got a really nice plastic cladding from the front bumper all the way down to the sides of the doors, kind of down towards the rockers. I like that. I think it's a great little look. It looks good with the adventurous kind of off-road style the Bronco Sport's going for. And honestly, if something happens, I'd much rather replace plastic than I would metal. Now, working our way through, we've got our really nice Badlands emblem there. Now, that is reflective in the night, so pretty cool look here as well. New mirrors here as well too. You're gonna have blind spot built into that with the Ford Copilot 360 Assist packaging. Proximity door handles, awesome feature. I love having that on my car right now. Just keep it in my pocket, walk up the door, boom, I can just get it right in. Don't have to worry about fumbling with my key. Now, like we talked about earlier, you're gonna have your roof rails here. You're also gonna have the kicked up hood. Kicked up roof, really, really great design. I'm a huge fan of that, I love that. Making our way to the back, and you can also see in the front is gonna be your 18-inch aluminum style wheel, machined aluminum. Great, great look. I think it looks awesome finished in the gray. It really complements on the channel black color. I think it looks great. Now, right at the back here, you're gonna have a nice little side glass here, very, very tinted, of course, same with your privacy glass tint on the passenger back here as well too. There's a really cool little hidden Easter egg. There's a handful of hidden Easter eggs all throughout the Bronco Sport. Well, there's a hidden one at the gas cap. I'll show you.
So hidden under the gas cap is a cool little hidden Easter egg. Of course, pretty common right now with the Easy Fuel. That's pretty standard for Ford. But right above that, you can see established 1966. You've got U15, U14 and U13 for the different styles that were available on the original first generation Bronco.
Now that we're at the back of the Bronco Sport, a couple things I want to note that are very exciting in my opinion. First thing is a lift glass. You got a little button right here, pop that, and you can lift it up from the back. That's the first time we've had that since probably 2012 with the outgoing old generation Escape. So access anything you want from the back here. Really, really exciting. I love having that back. Now there is a cool little hidden Easter egg of the old Bronco hidden right at the top of the lift glass that you can only see from the inside. Now close that, you got your button here. Now of course you're still gonna have your pop tailgate or your left tailgate. On the inside here is a handful of things, so let's open it up and we'll jump in.
Coming into the cargo space of the Bronco Sport, of course, you've got quite a bit of space. Very, very spacious in the back here for tools, adventure, gear, whatever it might be. Another cool little Easter egg hidden in the back here is actually when you pan over to these little tie downs, you can kind of see there's a little lasso there. And that's on all four. So you have it over on your corner here. You've got another one there. And also come over, you've got one and two right there. 12 volt outlet. Of course, you got your 400 watt 110 volt on the back. You're going to have your tie down points right there on each corner, right over there and down the corner there too. Couple cool things right at the back here. You are going to have a little light switch. You can click that guy on. So you can kind of see it turns on your little light switches on the corner of each of the tailgate. The inner tailgate piece. Now, shut that guy off. Another little cool feature is you do actually have on the passenger rear, you've got a little bottle opener there as well. Use that safely, just like I mentioned in the F-150 video. And at the back here, you've got dual close handles or dual grips. Now, nice thing is you've got dual struts on the back of the tailgate here. So if you're out using this for adventure, you can bring a coat hanger, you can hang anything off of that, and it'll be able to, of course, dry. Now, let's make our way to the rest of the back and make our way to the interior. Now, of course, with the Badlands being the top end, you are gonna have your backup camera just underneath the Bronco Sport logo. You're gonna have your backup sensors, of course. And now this one does have the optional rear tow package on, so that gets you up to 2,200 pounds of towing capacity on the Bronco Sport. Still usable. You can put maybe a little pop-up trailer tent on the back and tow it to your location. Now we'll head inside and we'll go through everything new in there. By far has to be my favorite part of the all new Bronco Sport is the interior, specifically the interior on this Badlands that I have here. It has got the beautiful ebony roast interior. You've got really, really nice brown, kind of soft touch leather style accents on the side. You've got a little bit of a darker brown outline there as well too. Really, really nice and simple, honestly, interior here, nothing too crazy. The Badlands and Outer Banks, you are able to get the B&O or Bang & Olufsen sound system. Now let's pan over to those seats. Honestly, I think this has to be my favorite interior I think I have seen in a long time in a Ford. Beautiful brown interior, kind of different, kind of contrasting brown. So light brown, you got your dark brown. Now up at the top here, you are gonna have like a suede style Alcantara, really nice headrest there as well. That's for all of the seats, all five seats have that style. Now let's jump in and we'll go through the opening display and what's still a little bit different on the inside there and what to expect. Now, when I hit the engine start stop button, you can see it lights up. It looks awesome. It's got a really, really cool kind of loading screen, looks like kind of pebbles or rocks rolling towards it. And it makes a really, really cool Bronco, Bucking Bronco logo there. Really, really cool, nice fade there too. Now, really, really similar steering wheel and kind of dash display to the Escape. Of course, it is based off of the Escape, so there is going to be some things that are shared, but one thing I noticed right off the bat and like is that your tach and your display is not the exact same from the Escape. You have kind of the Bronco kind of font. It looks really, really cool. I like it. On the left side here, of course, you're going to have your lane keep assist, your high beams, your marker lights, all that typical stuff. Now you do have on the 2-liter, so on the Badlands package, you do actually have paddle shifters. So gives you a nice little sporty feeling. You can kind of shift through the gears yourself. Now up on the dash there too, you are going to have your forward collision, your lane keep, all that typical Ford Copilot 360 assist stuff there too. Now on the steering wheel itself, really, really common for 2021 Ford vehicles. Pretty much reused everything here, so that stuff is all standard. Of course, you got a nice little Bucking Bronco on the side there too. Now, one thing I missed earlier in the video is you do have your reused kind of light switch here too. So you got your fog lights, your tailgate, and you've also got your automatic light switch and your dim up and dim down there too. Now in the center, really cool. You've got your engine start stop button, so your proximity key, like I mentioned earlier. You do have a really nice little kind of storage cubby right underneath the 8-inch touchscreen there too. I love it. I've got an iPhone 11 and that fits perfectly in there. It's a great little design. Now just underneath that, you do have your wireless charging pad right down there, USB-A and USB-C charging points there too. Dual climate control, so driver can be warm, passenger can be cool. You've got your heated seats for both driver and passenger, and you do have a heated steering wheel button, which I'm really happy to see. I love that Ford is bringing that to most of the vehicles, as before it was in the touchscreen. Now, panning your way down here, you do have your rotary gear shift dial. I like it. I think they've put like this kind of rubberized ring around it. I think it feels great. It looks awesome. It kind of goes with the adventure kind of off-road styling. Electronic parking brake, auto hold, and finally our GOAT modes. Now we'll get into our GOAT modes in 1 second. Before we get there, I just want to pan up and be able to show you the moonroof or the little sunroof that you've got. Nothing too crazy, but I feel it does a great job lighting the interior up and it gives you a nice little bit of space. It just does a really, really good job. Now let's get into those GOAT modes. GOAT modes is goes over any type of terrain. That is the throwback kind of nickname from when Ford was making the first Bronco. That's what they nicknamed it as a kind of the hidden name for it. Keep it under wraps.
Of course, you've got your four quadrants around here, a couple different things to note. So traction control, you're gonna have your trail control, so that's like an off-road cruise control. You're gonna have your locking rear diff, and you're gonna have your four-wheel drive lock. Now, your locking rear diff, I'm told that that actually shares the rear diff technology from the Focus RS, which is very exciting because that's got drift mode. You can send some power to the back. Now, going through all the different go modes, there are a handful. From normal, you've got your mud and ruts, you've got your eco, you've got your sport, you've got your slippery, and you have the rock crawl, and finally sand. Now, in the back of the Bronco Badlands, there is something that's really, really cool. It is specific to the Badlands package, but there's something else really cool back here that I think everyone's gonna like that is available in all the trims. First thing that is Badlands specific is you got a little storage spot kind of right underneath the rear seat. So you can put gloves or, you know, little hiking boots will fit in the back kind of little compartment there. Now on all of the Bronco Sports, you're actually gonna have these guys here, little saddles. You're gonna have a little storage spot, nice kind of like a harder plastic in there and a soft kind of interior of it there too. So you can put a laptop, your safe stuff, whatever you want. Can hang it in the back. Now on the bottom, you do have these little hooks where you can kind of hang your carabiners there. That's on the back of both driver and passenger seats. Now, of course, you're gonna have a little center console that can fold down there for the back passengers with your two cup holders there as well.
Thank you for tuning in, everyone. That is a wrap on the walk around video of a 2021 Ford Bronco Sport. Now this walk around video has been specific to the Badlands package. Base Big Bend Outer Banks is a little bit different. I did get an Outer Banks in at the same time as I received this Badlands. I should have that video posted in about a week's time. We'll go through everything that's different on the Outer Banks versus the Badlands. As always, thank you for coming out. Like, comment, and subscribe. If I missed something, if I should do something next time, let me know in the comments down below. Thanks for tuning in. See you next time.